Good morning, students. After a short break last week, you were not given anything of studies. Now, after a short break, we'll begin again our regular studies. I hope that everybody is back again with the work. Okay. Today, in English, we are going to learn parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech. These parts of speech you have learned from standard 3rd or 4th. Everybody knows about this, but now we are going to learn them in detail, whatever. Let's see which all are the parts of speech. They are, first is noun, second pronoun, third adjective, fourth verb. Even though in the textbook there may be sequence may be changed of these, but why I am giving this way, I'll tell you now. Adjective, then verb, then adverb, preposition, conjunction, and finally interjection. These are 8 parts of speech. First 3 parts of speech, if you see here, noun, pronoun, and adjective. These 3 parts of speech are related to noun only. Now, pronoun we use in place of noun, so that is related to noun. Adjective means qualities which we apply for noun only, and so these 3 must be written in first sequence. There is no connection of adjective or pronoun with verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, or interjection even. So, the sequence must be given this way only. Okay. Noun, pronoun, adjective. Then verb. Verb and adverb, these are correlated, interrelated. Verb and adverb. After that, preposition and conjunction, these 2 are related. They connect noun or pronoun with verb or adverb. Okay, so there is connection between these 2, and finally interjections are expressive words, sudden expressions. We are going to study them, each and every part of speech, in detail now. Ready all? Okay, so first part of speech is nouns. What is a noun? Noun is naming word, name of certain things. Now here, if you see around me, there are many things around me. Everything carries one specific name. For example, this is a chalk. Can I call it a duster? No. Or what is this particular thing? This is blackboard. I cannot call it as a chalk. So names of the things around us, they are known as nouns. Nouns means, in short, names of what? Things, places, person, material, or animals. Nouns means names of things, person, animal, material, or things. So these are called as nouns. Nouns are again categorized in 5 types. There are actually 10 types of nouns, but they are ahead. Next year you will be taught those rest 5 parts of nouns. So nouns, first thing is common noun. Common means what? Whatever is common everywhere, same features for certain things. Now when we talk about this chalk, chalk means a material which is used to write on somewhere. Not necessarily on the board, we can write anywhere with the chalk. It is made of certain particular thing. Whenever you hear the name chalk, certain thing comes in front of you. You view that one certainly. So common nouns, common things around us. They are common, having common features. Okay. Next is proper. proper, the word only tells us that it is proper, certain specific name given to specific thing. For example, name of our city. City is common noun because cities are seen around us everywhere. But what is the name of our city? Kolhapur. So Kolhapur can be mentioned as proper noun, whereas city can be named as common noun. So proper nouns means names, particular names given to particular things or particular people, and these are called as proper nouns. Examples: names of countries, names of rivers, names of seas, names of people, names of cities, anything. Names, proper names given to proper things, proper nouns. Next is collective noun. Collective, the word only tells us that collection of something. Collectively, a group is named as one noun. For example, there are many grapes. Togetherly, what we call it, bunch of grapes. Or flowers kept in one vessel together, we call it as bouquet of flowers. So when the nouns, when the things are collectively together, they are called as collective nouns. An army of what? Soldiers. So together, when the soldiers come, they are known as army. And so collective nouns means collection of something. Next is abstract nouns. Abstract means what? Vague, unclear. Abstract nouns are generally the qualities of people or living things, you can say, or even non-living things, no problem, no worries about that. So abstract nouns, qualities which we cannot touch or smell or see, those are abstract nouns. For example, here I am writing a happy child. Now child is common noun. Child means a small person. Child, common noun. Whenever I say happy, happiness is common noun. Happy is adjective here. So happiness, when I add up there N-E-S-S suffix to that, that becomes happiness. Happiness you cannot see, you cannot touch, you cannot smell even. So the qualities which you cannot see, smell, touch, they are known as abstract nouns. And finally, material nouns. Material which cannot be counted in numerals. Pay attention, material which cannot be counted in numerals, they are called as material nouns. For example, oil or milk, you cannot count that in numerals, so they are called as material nouns. Done this one? So nouns have five types. These are common noun, proper noun, collective, abstract and material noun. Okay, noun is clear to you. Second thing is pronouns. Pronouns means what basically? The word pronoun tells us that instead of noun, whenever we use some new word, different word in place of noun, that is called as pronoun. For example, a certain boy or girl named so and so, whenever we talk about that person, we do not say always that, for example, again some particular name must be taken, and if I say Sheetal, Sheetal is a good girl, Sheetal is a studious girl, Sheetal is an intelligent girl. Instead of saying Sheetal, 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 which word should I say? She. She is a pronoun. And so pronoun means what? The word which we use in place of noun is called as pronoun. Now there are eight types of pronouns. which you have never seen before. Now henceforth you will study these all in detail in our regular syllabus, not here, because in this scholarship they have asked only parts of speech 8. So I will not explain this here, but I'll certainly explain you all these types of pronouns. First is personal pronoun. Personal, related to person. I, we, you, he, she, it, and they, finally, these all are personal pronouns. Secondly, possessive. Possessive means what? Possession of somebody. Now this chalk, when I say it is in my hand, belongs to me. So whatever thing belongs to a certain person, that is called possessive pronouns, and those are my, our, your, his, her, its, and their. These are all possessive pronouns, which tells us that possession of somebody. Next is intensive or reflexive pronouns. They reflex. Now I, whenever I talk about myself, what does it reflex? Myself. When I say myself, the word reflexes me. So myself, yourself, herself, himself, themselves, yourselves, etc. All these are reflexive pronouns. The next is relative pronoun. Relative, the pronouns which relate to clauses. That is again a deep concept, will not understand now, will be taught in deep. Relative pronouns, just do remember the types. Next is reciprocal pronoun. This is also somewhat complicated concept, will be taught later. Reciprocal pronoun. Then demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrate means what? To show. Demonstrate. When I say about blackboard, what should I call it? This is the blackboard. When I talk about that person, I show there my finger, I say that. So this, that, these, those are demonstrative pronouns which shows something nearly object or far away object. Then interrogative pronouns. All WH words, they are called as interrogative pronouns. And finally, indefinite pronouns. So this one, relative pronoun, reciprocal pronoun, and indefinite pronouns, they are complicated concepts, will be taught later. And finally, adjectives. Now in adjectives, we have learnt till last year that there are only two types of adjectives. Those are qualitative and quantitative adjectives, but actually there are many types of adjectives. Okay, how many are they? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 types of adjectives. There are certain more also, but I am taking in short here. Whichever is very, very important, that only will be taught now. And among these also, there are somewhere complicated concepts which will be taught to you later. So descriptive pronouns, they describe something, qualities almost. Quantitative, quantity is shown among that. Proper pronouns, proper, certain thing. Then numerous, numbers, all numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Demonstrative pronouns, again the same. They demonstrate something. For example, that person. When I say that person, person is noun, and so that is called as demonstrative adjective. Distributive, this is also complicated, and demonstrative is also somewhat, and proper is also somewhat, even descriptive. So these four will be taught to you later when you will come to school, or if is possible somewhere, I'll make a video and send you that also. Next is interrogative. Again the same thing, all WH words are considered as interrogative pronouns, adjectives. And then finally possessive adjectives. Possessive, my, whenever I say my chalk. Chalk is a noun, my is adjective, and here my chalk, whenever I say my, is considered as possessive adjective. Okay, up to here I think you all are clear. Next, this verb adverb will be taken in one part. Preposition, conjunction, interjection will be taught in another part. Three videos you are going to get today, and you are expected to see, watch carefully all those videos, which you will definitely do. I'm sure about that. Okay, students.